Hey.
Yes?
I know you, I think. Are you the brave soul building up towns with those pre-war gadgets? ASAMs, right?
Who are these people?
Mostly these are folks that got turned away from Diamond City. On account of being ghouls, suspected synths, contagious, poor, or just unsightly. We take everyone and anyone we can, and the guards are happy to send them our way. A little too happy. So I guess you could easily be another lost soul turned away at the gates. But something tells me you're a bit too important for that.
Yeah, that's me.
That's exciting. I've been hoping to meet you. And here you are, wandering right into our humble... let's just go with camp. This place makes for a shit hospital. Though we've certainly had enough patients to fill a proper one by now. I'm Fiona. I represent the Nightingales. We're a small group of doctors, though I suppose that word might mean something different to you than to us. I doubt you've heard much of us out there, but you might have come across one of our medical supply caches out in the Commonwealth. I hope this isn't presumptuous, but after everything we've heard about you, we would like to help you.
Oh? What have you heard?
You're making waves with what you're building. We've actually had quite a few patients that were on their way to one of your settlements. I try to stay in contact with whoever I can after they're better. When they leave our care, they're skeptical, but willing to risk the journey. I hear back from so many of them, and they all sound hopeful, sometimes even happy. Anyone who is able to provide that is an ally in my book.
What are you offering exactly?
I'm sure you have people capable of treating wounds and rads, or at least a supply of chems that do the job. We, however, know more about contemporary diseases than anyone else in the Commonwealth. And trust me, they've mutated quite a bit since the bombs. And obviously, there's the basics that even medics forget about when trying to build a healthy community. I hear a lot about your ASAMs, but has anyone thought to build a cemetery with them yet? And I don't mean the shallow grave variety that's in style.
I get it. Sounds like an important step.
So you're already aware of how important safe corpse disposal is, especially during disease outbreaks. I'm glad to hear that.
I'm in. Let's do this.
Hold on. You might still say no in a minute. I wish my pitch didn't come with a but it does. Right now, enthusiasm aside, we're limited in how much help we can offer. We're a small group in a dangerous world, and we often work for free. So, the catch here is that we can help you in the long run, but it will take a bit of work first. And investment, I suppose. So, I'm hoping you'll still agree. And I'm also hoping you won't mind starting the partnership with going to rescue someone.
Why do I have to be involved in this?
We're a small group. All of us know how to defend ourselves, but we can't leave our patients. And the volunteers that guard us aren't up for the risk. Not for Raphael, anyway.
Shouldn't be a problem. Just tell me where they are.
I wanted to be able to bring a better offer to the table, so I took a chance on the information broker in Diamond City. And he came through. But... well, he dug up some pre-war records about a shipment of medical equipment that was meant to arrive in port right before the bombs. The ship got delayed, or stopped, or something, but it never made it to port. But the Ron went and even located the wreck for me from rumors. Point is, Raphael, one of our guards, went to check it out and see if anything can be recovered. He hasn't been back, and we're worried.
I'll find him. You have my word.
There's the breath I've been holding. I'm glad your reputation holds up. I wasn't sure how much I could rely on rumor. I'll put the location on the map. It's underwater, but speak to Ellis before you go. He has something to help with that. And of course, you're welcome to make yourself at home here.
That's all for now. Thanks.
Everything all right?
I keep telling those idiots, you can't get superpowers by chugging glowing blood.
Here, I have the chems already.
What are you talking about?
You're the one going after Raphael, right? Which means you'll have to go underwater after him. These chems help with that. Don't ask how. I mean, you can ask, but it's nothing I could explain, honestly. It just works. I hope.
Thanks, I guess.
Oh, sorry, I thought you just wanted, you know, grab and go. Mercenary types tend to have no patience for the details. Not that I'm implying that you're a mercenary type, I just went with the safest option, but now I realize it probably came off as rude instead. And I still haven't even said hello or introduced myself. Sorry, I'm Ellis.
I'll take some.
Oh, right. Here you go, and here's some extra. You know, for Raphael. In case he ran out and got stuck in the boat. Ship, I mean.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm the least important person here, trust me. I'm not even a doctor yet. I'm still studying and practicing, but I'll get there.
What do you know about him?
About Raphael? I'm not too worried about him. He's tough. It's why Fiona trusted him with this. He probably just got delayed or stuck somewhere.
I have to go.
Stay safe out there. Not that you need the reminder.
You're the one Fiona's been fawning over. You must be an important guest, seeing how she emphatically told me not to glare and scare. Tell me, do you feel important?
Yep, I'm the best.
You stepped up when no one else would. Nothing wrong with taking pride in that. An attitude like that can help one carry more weight than perhaps they'd ever have expected. So, our little VIP, what might I help you with? Is this about Raphael? Or perhaps you're here to share some gossip?
What about him?
Raphael is a stubborn one. He has an underdeveloped survival instinct and a love affair with adrenaline. Both he and Fiona often forget that he's only lived this long on sheer luck. And that luck always runs out when you least expect it. But let us hope that he still has more to spare.
Who are you?
I'm the grumpy old lady of the Nightingales. The one that Fiona wheels out whenever she needs the naughty children to behave. I'm also the group's founder. But it'll be more fun if you refer to me as its resident witch. It makes explaining my treatment methods far simpler.
What are they?
My methods. Same as any doctor. However, it's my process that people seem to question more than anything. You see, I prefer innovation and more adaptive, sustainable forms of medicine. But most consider something like grinding up hub flour to be beneath them. They'd rather risk life and limb scavenging ancient stim packs from ghoul-infested ruins.
There's more to this, isn't there?
Such a precocious VIP. You're giving this little old lady far more attention than she's deserved in decades. But I assure you, in a week of traveling, you'll see and hear hundreds of things far more interesting than my life story.
I have to go.
Do take care.
Diamond City is one of the best places to get proper care, but they shut their doors on those who truly need it. It's not fair.
As of October 23rd, 2077. All engineering and facilities staff, report to emergency stations. All non-essential personnel, report to muster stations. Catastrophic damage to main reactor. Engine and rudder non-responsive. Hull breach in compartments 3B forward to 5D mid starboard side. Taking on one.
Figured Fiona would wait at least a week before sending in a rescue. So, you the cavalry? If I didn't know better, I'd think she was having a big laugh at my expense right about now. And after I'd made a friend, too.
Who are you? What are you doing out here?
I'm Raphael, the guy you were probably asked to rescue. If it ain't obvious already, you didn't stumble here on accident. And, right now, mostly I press random buttons. Eat canned beans, and kick that dead robot until my leg hurts and I feel better. It's not one of the anger management things Alice tried teaching me. But hey, kicking shit is still a time-honored tradition.
That's right. I'm here to rescue you.
Much as I hate to get between you and your pay for a job well done, I'm not leaving just yet. Didn't come here just for sightseeing. Of course, I ran into a bit of a problem with that. Thought I'd swim through a big hole in the side. Take out a couple of Mirelurks, be on my way. You any good with this techie stuff? So I'll give her to me. And pressing buttons just made it worse.
That shouldn't be a problem.
Be my guest. If you need anything from Rusty, let me know. We got a rapport going. Now that's a beautiful sound. Come on, let's see what all the security is for.
Intruder, identify yourself.
Engineering staff, reroute power from auxiliary generators.
This
main reactor has
clear.
Been lost.
Proceeding
prioritize repairs to water pump
protocol.
Systems. All non-essential staff, begin lifeboat launch procedures.
False alarm. Standing. Now false upper alarm. And line.
Right there.
Excuse me.
Zombie white cells, Cassandra calls this sort of thing. The robots of pre-war ruins, I mean. Don't ask me why. I don't get half the shit she says. Hey.
Unidentified intruder. Detect hostile target. Identified.
Over there!
Insufficient power from auxiliary systems. All watertight doors non-responsive from decks 2 to 5.
Yet.
What is that ship doing? We're just wasting space.
Hold up a second. I think this might be something. Still intact. Huh. Thal. Pathology. Damn. Nearly strained something on that one.
What's the problem?
Can't read. Thought it was pretty obvious. Never really bothered learning. Da tried teaching me, but he croaked before it took. Ellis got it into his head to teach me. Kid's a weird one, though. Heart bleeding worse than Fiona's. And that's saying something. Guess I should have tried a little harder, considering the kind of shit I'm volunteering for.
Why don't you tell me what's so interesting about this?
Don't know. Oh, why do they make the words so tiny? My eyes are swimming just looking at them. I know the word pathology, though. It's what Cassandra does, or studies, or whatever. Maybe these are textbooks or journals or something. Crates look heavy. Might be sealed well enough to survive the swim back, though. If it doesn't take me to the bottom with it. What do you figure?
No problem. I'd be glad to help.
Guess hauling shit out of holes in the ground's nothing new to you, huh? All right. Suit yourself. What's up? More of this shit. What's the point of having more than one locked door? Are these ships meant to double as forts or something?
Limited power restored to deck 4-6. All engineering personnel are hereby instructed to cease restoration of system power and report to muster stations.
Not gonna lie. I was kinda hoping we'd find nothing.
Yeah? Why is that?
Fiona and Cassandra have been arguing about the ship for weeks. Fiona going on about valuable pre-war technology and recovering research. Cassandra thought this was a waste of time. That Fiona's wasting caps and energy, searching for a pre-war solution to post-war problems. Again, I got fed up with listening to that shit and came out here to check it out. What's the point of arguing if you don't know anything survived, right?
What do you think?
Fiona's not wrong. All this science shit buried in the rubble? The pre-war guns fire better than a jury-rigged pipe pistol. So who knows? But I figure Cassandra's got the right of it. It's just chasing around ghosts. Good for a thrill. But it'll break your heart eventually.
Tell me the next step, then.
What are you looking at me for? I don't know what this shit is. It's probably not pre-war Instamash. Unless they took it that seriously. Never seen anything like it before. I don't know, you're the brains here. And hey, look, a terminal that probably has everything you need to know. Why the hell did I sign up for this shit?
This is Captain Alice. All hands, abandon ship. We are breaking procedure. Do not head towards Boston. I repeat, do not head to Boston. We are redirecting lifeboats north until fuel runs out.
Well?
Worth hauling it back? Or are we just gonna pretend this room is empty?
I have something for you.
What? From Alice, yeah. I told that kid. If I'm not back in a couple of days, I'm probably dead. Should've figured. Thanks. I still had some handy, but, yeah. Always good to have extras.
Sounds like just what we need right now.
If you say so. Let's hope this is worth the frostbite. Cool. Alright, all set. Let's get out of here. I can make my own way back now. Meet back up at the hospital. Fiona will want to throw some caps your way. Gotta be joking, Fee.
This is what we do. You know that better than anyone.
You hear gunshots every minute in this hellhole. Doesn't mean you gotta chase down each bullet. It's probably just super mutants.
I don't think so. Guard said it came from the direction of the pre-war hospital, and there was laser weapon fire.
Gunners. Even better. Come on, Fiona. Just let one go for a change. Don't you have enough sick folks here?
Oh, there you are. I'm glad to see you safe and sound. And Raphael, too. Here, we didn't agree on payment, but I'd like to give you what I can.
Thank you. That's kind of you.
I wish I had time to stick around and ask about everything that happened, but there's been a bit of an emergency.
Gunshots downtown is not an emergency, Fee. It's a fact of life.
Raphael.
Bleeding f***ing hearts. All of you. Fine. I'll go on ahead. And make sure it's not some asshole using ferals for practice.
It's good to have him back safe. We're heading out to the old hospital downtown. If you'd like to see what we do in the field, or just lend a hand, you're welcome to join us there.
What exactly is this place?
Mass Bay Medical Center, I think it was called pre-war. It's in a dangerous spot, but we should be all right for the moment. I think it was held by gunners last, but we've never had them shoot at us before.
I'll meet you there.
Shouldn't be too much trouble. Gunfire's died down already. Thanks again for getting Raphael back. I'm sure he'll fill us in what happens soon. And what these crates are all about. Well, something for later.
Everything all right?
Let me see that. Yeah. Might want to use that stim before it swells. Better use of it than playing doctor with this waste of skin.
What? No, it's just a bruise. This man is going to die if I don't...
Exactly. I say let him croak.
You broke Fiona's nose when we found you in that wreckage. Should we have left you to die there too?
Worked out peaches and cobble for me. Doesn't make it any fucking smarter. You want to tell the kid to stop wasting supplies on psychos?
We're here to tend to anyone that needs help, not play judge and jury.
What are you two arguing about anyway?
This piece of shit just tried to kill the kid, then passed out before I could haul him off.
He was just startled and he thought he was fighting for his life. You can hardly hold it against him. You acted the same way when we-
You spin the fucking barrel every time you put your hands on a dying asshole still high on psycho. That makes you an idiot, not a hero. Don't kid yourself. I know his type. All he wants is to take you to hell with him. So just let me send him on his fucking way already.
He deserves to live.
I'm stabilizing him. It's the right thing to do. If you don't like it, you should just...
I should just what? Leave you alone with a psycho killer? You want to waste supplies, fine. But Cassie will have my hide if he rips your throat out.
I... injected him with a tranquilizer. When he was on me, I mean. He'll be out for a long time. I think. Or it was blood loss. Maybe both.
Why didn't you say that? Shit. There's hope for you yet, kid.
Hi.
Hey. Is it just me? Or does this whole thing feel... I don't know, weird. Won't hurt to stay on guard.
I'll be careful. Thanks.
Now if only the kid would say that every now and again. Looks like it's handled down here. I'm gonna get upstairs, back Fiona up. You coming?
Excuse me.
It's just garbage. I toss it.
Hey.
Hey. This is a pretty big place. Always wondered about how they manage this kind of thing. You know, before the bombs. Not just building it, but staffing and funding and supplying. Guess it's easier when there's no mutants or raiders, huh? Times like this, I get Fiona's little obsession with the old world. It's like being inside a broken clock, wondering how the gears fit together.
This place seems familiar. I think I saw a bit about it on the news back before the war.
Huh? Oh, you mean those old tapes. Fiona found an old recording of a weather report once. Wonder what it takes to predict snow 2 days ahead. I'll bet it was something less depressing than Gunner on Raider Shootout in decrepit hospital. Feels like this place deserves... better.
That's all for now.
Well now, if it isn't our VIP. Come to help or just observe?
What's going on here?
Not all patients wander into our care on their own 2 feet. Usually the ones who need aid the most are those left in the wake of combat. To find them, it's as easy as following the sounds of gunshots. But even then, it can take some persuasion before they're willing to let you treat them.
Here to help.
It would appear we have similar goals. I'm glad to hear it. If you really wish to assist, then I could use a second opinion on this corpse. There. Do you see that?
Why do you ask?
Oh, humor an old woman, would you? Sometimes it's just about getting a second opinion from a colleague.
Yes, of course.
As I thought, the skin discoloration, sunken eyes, the apparent expiration from relatively minor wounds, and other bodies showed similar symptoms. I believe this gunner squadron was sick. Strange. Usually gunners have the resources to combat wasteland diseases. If I were to guess, I'd say this was cholera. Perhaps a mutated strain, but I can't know for sure without testing. Regardless, I would refrain from drinking the water around. There were survivors from this little shootout. A handful of gunners. Fiona's been trying to coax them out of hiding. They may be infected as well. If you speak to the gunners, it might be worth mentioning that we have the means of diagnosing and curing them.
Not looking worse for the wear.
Hey.
The rest of my friends are tending to wounded downstairs already. Please, if you'll just listen.
You're wasting your damn breath, and you're still in our territory. The guns stay up until you...
We're not raiders or scavvers, all right? We're doctors. We're here to help. I see several bad breaks. That one isn't putting enough pressure on...
I'm losing my patience. If you don't get the hell out of here and... Are you kidding? There's more of you?
Keep talking to her like that, and I'll shoot you myself. Doesn't look like you bastards are long for this world anyhow.
Raphael, you're not helping.
This lot is a waste of time in MedStock. I'd almost hate to waste the ammo putting them down.
Raphael! Go find a rock and growl at it until you feel up to rejoining civilized discussions again. This is awkward.
Can you bring me up to speed on the situation?
The remaining gunners are still healthy enough to shoot at us and paranoid enough that they're very likely to. They're desperate and think they're backed into a corner. But I've been shouting across the room to their commander for an hour now. Never known gunners to bark that long if they were really intending to start shooting. Though that doesn't mean that they won't if we make a move. They'll wear themselves out eventually, but some of them might be in critical condition. The sooner I get to them, the better their odds.
Maybe I can reason with them.
Is that a good idea? Considering, you know, your involvement with the coup at Gunner's Plaza?
Of killing gunners? Might work. Or they might start shooting as soon as they get a good look at you. V, start getting behind me, just in case.
Well, just remember, the Nightingales came here to help survivors, not slaughter them.
Why can't you assholes just leave us alone? We're holding this hospital on gunner business, which doesn't involve you, so get out.
Who are you people, exactly?
I'm Commander Yorks. Field promoted this morning. I already know who you are. I really don't care what went down at the plaza, and the last thing I want is to get my remaining men killed. But if you're here on some campaign to exterminate gunners, I warn you, we'll fight to the death. So it's best if you just leave.
Okay, calm down and take a deep breath. If you're sick, I want to help you.
Look, you can't help us, and I don't trust you, so... You want this place? Fine. Just let us leave, okay? Not like we'll be able to hold it anyway.
You need to get treatment before you put any more lives at risk. She has medicine that will treat you.
Please, just let us dress your wounds and try to cure whatever is wrong. You'll be free to leave anytime you want, I promise.
There's gotta be a catch, dammit. Raiders I get, but what the hell is your angle?
I get it. You're searching for a catch. If it'll make you feel better accepting our help, you can gift us some hospital supplies once we're done.
You cure whatever's wrong with us. You can keep the whole damn hospital. But I'm watching all of you, especially the asshole running his mouth.
I also use it to bite. Don't forget that.
Good work. I know you had no reason to do that, considering they're gunners, but you talked them down anyway. I don't know if we'll be able to cure them, but I know their chances are better with us than out there on their own. So, they might not be thanking you for it, but I will. Thank you. I wonder if we can't get some of this hospital's equipment up and running again. It's definitely bigger than our place by Diamond City. It is more dangerous out here, of course. And I'll have to talk it over with the others. In any case, we'll explore this place a bit and see what we can find. I'll put some aside for you, so come back in a couple days if you like. And thanks for being here today.
Hi.
Oh, hey. I did promise to set aside a reward for you. Here. There's also a locker where we stash what we took off the bodies as well. You're free to it. Oh, and more importantly, here's some schematics for your ASAMs. I composited them from the hospital records on sanitation.
Thank you.
No, thank you. With your tech and initiative, every settlement can now have proper health measures. It might not see immediate return, but trust me, in the long run, it'll make a big difference for survival. That's all I had. Cersei is out right now, but I can patch you up if you need.
If we're going to be working as a team, we should get to know each other better.
You mean me, personally? You know, I can't remember the last time I said anything about myself that didn't relate to the Nightingales. What would you like to know?
So you're a doctor?
Seemed like the most direct way of helping people, and there isn't a town out here that doesn't welcome a doctor, so it's an easy way to travel. I'm not exactly a prodigy with it, but I had more wanderlust back then, so I gave it my best shot. It's how I ended up bumping into the Nightingales.
Tell me more.
I found one of my routine stops raised to the ground one day. I went to help, and Cassandra was already there, looking like she'd been at it for days. There were people with her, mostly keeping watch, but it was easy to tell she was in charge. I joined in. It wasn't until later that I noticed the patients weren't just on the defending side. She didn't care. Even shouted down one of the guards that tried to finish off one of the raiders. Some of those townsfolk had been my friends, but what she was doing struck something with me. A long talk with her later and the rest is history.
Who were you before all this?
I did a bit of everything, so I don't really have a word for what I was. I sort of traveled and made myself useful where I could. Sometimes doctoring, sometimes I traded or helped with farm work, built water purifiers, taught kids. Sometimes all I did was listen to people.
Tell me more.
I found...
That's all for now.
Of course. Was there anything else?
Anything else need doing?
Work is never done. I'm a bit busy with some of the pre-war diagnostic machines, seeing if I can get them up and running. Everyone else has been really busy getting this place set up and secure. Maybe you can check in with them, see if they need anything.
I should get going.
If you'd be stopping by. Listen, I got an escort errand to run. If you're interested in coming with, won't take long.
Sure thing.
Caravan was coming by way of Diamond City. Safer route through there. If we check the street west, we'll probably run into them. And if we're lucky, there's something to shoot on the way. You take point. I'll watch your back.
Those straps will hold him.
Then go fetch Raphael to pin the patient down. Or ready another dose of sedative.
No! No, no, we can't keep sedating him. It can't be good for the patient. And we should give Raphael a break. He's already done a lot.
Oh, you think yourself more capable of wrestling with an unruly patient. I can't tell if that's arrogance or misplaced compassion.
Misplaced? After everything he's done for us, just because he's... He could have been hurt, all just to keep the rest of us safe.
Ellis, enough. Sulking has its place, but that place is not during a biopsy.
Cersei's gotta lighten up. Omen of death, my ass. Never dig a grave before you got a corpse to bury.
Hmm? Oh, yes. Seems poor Ellis is at war with himself. He so desperately wants to do the right thing. But the right thing is so often elusive. You make decisions as to what's right and wrong daily, don't you? Tell me, this patient here. A raider, by profession. Most likely responsible for many vile deeds. In your opinion, is this patient better off dead?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Ah, perhaps you're hearing that little voice in the back of your head. The one that asks, what if? What if someone else needs this medicine more? What if this raider goes on to kill an innocent family? What if, what if, what if? Ellis is struggling because he's confronted by too many options, but he's unable to embrace any of them.
What do you think?
I think Ellis is young and has a lot to learn. Violence especially seems to unnerve him. He tries to hide behind Nightingale's teachings to protect himself. But despite appearances, the Nightingales are not pacifists.
The kid's smart. Smarter than you realize.
Oh, I know. He's also more headstrong than he first appears. Given enough time, I believe he'll find what's right for him. But enough about that. I'm glad you stopped by. I've heard you have a curious little gadget called a Vitomatic. Let me see it, please.
Of course. Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, and don't worry. I would never scan you without your consent. Now, let's see. As I thought. This little device is confused by post-war mutations. I've reset its scanning parameters. That should allow it to diagnose common diseases.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll come in handy.
You're welcome. Come.
Excuse me.
Well, shit. Super mutants. And here I thought I'd be setting up shop next to the combat zone that would cause problems. Funny. Nightingales found me in a wrecked caravan just like this one. I have to ask the kid if there's some fancy word for it.
Tangle with super mutants?
Nope. Not super mutants. Raiders. My gang, actually. I was one of the attackers.
What do you mean? What happened?
We got stupid. We're desperate. Can't remember anymore. Caravan had too many guns to be a safe bet. But it was the first we'd seen in weeks. Funny thing. Wouldn't have shot anyone if they'd just let us. But they fought back. Ended up a bloodbath. All of them. Half of us. And me. Afterwards, my friends took the loot and left me bleeding out in the dirt. Being honest, I wasn't expecting any different.
What happened after that?
Don't really remember. Alice says I fought back when they found me. But I can't remember anything until I woke up a couple of days later. Figured they confused me for a caravan hand or something. Then I got bored of just lying around, so I stopped ignoring the kids' chatter. Turns out, they knew who I was. Fiona gave me her usual bull about second chances. Dumbest shit I ever heard, at the time. Probably still is. Was planning to walk off as soon as my legs healed. And I guess I just never got around to it. Never was one for plans, anyway. Anyway, that's probably... Oh, shit. You hear that? For this bullshit.
I'll have a show a girl a good time.
Should have figured they'd stick it out in case it brought other idiots in. It's a classic. I'll see what I can salvage from this pile and meet you back in the hospital. Still in one piece?
Hello. You know, I always thought being a doctor would be the easiest thing in the world. If someone is sick, you cure them. If they're hurting, you treat it. Maybe Raphael is right, you know? Maybe Cassandra is right. Maybe even when you're trying to do the good thing, it's still... Sorry, you probably didn't walk up to me just to hear me ramble. Is there something I can do for you?
What's his story?
We picked him up nearby, I think. Definitely a raider. Raphael said something about Bosco's guy, but I don't really know what or who that is. He's been a bit... Well, I hate to say it, but feral comes to mind. Mumbling nonsense, snapping teeth, fighting us at every turn. We had to strap him down and sedate him. I don't even know if he wants our help with how hard he was fighting back. Raphael was stronger, but...
You did your best.
I'm starting to wonder... What if he'd really hurt Raphael, or killed someone, or he's in a lot of pain and we can't help him anyway? Well, no one got hurt this time. Fiona thinks she can get one of the diagnostic machines running, but Cassandra's probably already figured it out. We have those vials you and Raphael recovered from the ship. Helped us treat the cholera Yorks and his men had. But we had a diagnosis there. It's just... a lot to take in. Sorry, I didn't mean to ramble more at you.
Thank you. There you are. Listen, thanks for the head today. Being around these bleeding heart pacifists all day, it's nice to get out there and put the gun to use. And, about the shit I said. You know, about how I hooked up with the Nightingales. Anyway, I'm off to tell Fee what went down. See you around. Hey, Fee. About that. You all
right? Oh, yes. Lots to do, that's all. Did you end up going out there to meet the late caravan, or do I even need to ask?
Super mutant ambush. I brought back what I could carry.
I'm sure you did what you could. I'll let Bunker Hill know. Let's hope Cersei comes through on this opportunity of hers. What?
You're going to sleep sometime this month. No offense, but by the way you're swaying, I wouldn't let you so much as take my temperature right now.
I'll make you a deal. I'll sleep when you put your gun down for 2 minutes.
Your funeral.
Glad to see you're back safe. And I'm sorry to hear about the caravan. Besides the loss of lives, this won't make a convincing case that we're worth visiting out here. In any case, is there something I can help you with?
What's next for you?
There's something else that needs doing, but it requires traveling. Cersei is out on an interview, and I'd like you to back her up.
No problem. I'd be glad to help.
I'll mark the meeting spot on your map. Cersei will be waiting for you just outside. Stay safe out there.
Out of my element here.
Are you okay?
Yeah, just a bit jittery. Fiona's the talker usually. She has a way of phrasing even go to hell a way that makes people ask for directions. But it's my contact, and the whole logistics thing is also kind of my problem. I'll be happy if we just avoid bloodshed.
That's why I'm here.
I appreciate it, really. These guys are a bit... Well, they're not local, and they do things their own way. Unpredictable. They make me nervous. It's a bit odd seeing the new Liberty Training Company in the Commonwealth. Guess something caught their attention.
Who are these people?
Some kind of merchant coalition, I think? From south along the coast. Or was it north? The important part is they're offering to fund us. But I've been around long enough to know if something feels too good to be true, it probably is. And their pitch? Too good to ignore.
All right, let's get started.
Yeah. If they're for real, we could start dreaming bigger with this whole hospital idea. Train new doctors, keep all the caches stocked properly. I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's just get through this meeting and hope my bad luck's on break for today, yeah? I sure do feel better with a couple of ex-gunners for backup, though. Shows we're not pushovers. One more thing. If at any point you think it's a bad deal, just say so and we'll walk away. Fiona will understand. I'm from the Nightingales. Got a meeting. So far, so good, I think.
Yes. Lydia Proudmore. I'm your contact for today's negotiations. You must be Dr. Cersei. You're late.
Late? We didn't even set a time, just a day.
Ah, that's right. I understand working clocks are somewhat rare in this region. My clerk must have tried to accommodate you. A pity he failed to mention that to me, or I wouldn't have had to wait for 3 hours in this, well, whatever it was.
Oh, sorry to keep you waiting, Miss Proudmore.
Can't be helped, I'm sure. Let's proceed. In this envelope are the details of the sums the NLTC would like to invest in your organization. If you're agreeable to our terms, the first shipment will be forwarded to your location beginning of...
That's... Miss... This is a lot of caps. Antiseptic... Copper... Lenses... Wait... Did you say first shipment?
That's right. You seem surprised. Those are the estimated startup costs for an organization such as yourself, are they not?
And then some. But I mean... Last time I saw a caravan be this generous, they set up their own guys and tried to rip off the town for the losses.
A brazen tactic to be expected of the small fish that swim in this small pond. We do not operate through such petty maneuvers. I assure you, there is no clause in our prospective agreement about losses. The NLTC will assume all responsibility of security during delivery.
But...
It's a generous offer we're putting on the table, Doctor. One that I can just as easily take to many other initiatives in this territory. Your friend here has certain ventures that I'm sure could use those finances. Yours is simply one with the most promise for the investment.
That's right, my friend. I'd like to talk to them for a second, privately.
By all means, but I require an answer before you leave this room today. I have no intention of staying here longer than I absolutely have to.
I don't like it. That has to be the longest stick I've ever seen up anyone's ass. Every alarm bell is going off right now, but I can't figure out what her angle is.
Do you believe her?
They have a reputation for honoring written contracts, at least from what I've heard. If it's on paper, they mean it, but... Well... This paper doesn't say anything about intentions. It does have a lot of pretty big numbers, though.
Sounds like just what we need right now.
It does. Guess I have no room to question goodwill considering what the Nightingales do. This Lydia just rubs me the wrong way. She doesn't strike me as someone who'd hand over all this stuff to some group of doctors miles away from home, no strings, no motive. So, what do you think? Should we take it?
Are there any other options?
I don't know. Do you have a pile of caps lying around that you'd be willing to give to us? No strings attached?
I sure do.
Wait, really? Huh. I should have probably asked before we walked in here, then. Well, I guess that takes care of the necessity part. Thank you. We can still take her up on the deal, though, if you think it's worth it. Double the resources?
From what I just heard, that might be a bad idea.
You reckon? All right, I'll trust your judgment. I'll go let her know. Miss Proudmore, thank you for meeting me here today, but I'm afraid I'll have to decline your generous offer.
How disappointing. I'd hoped to find the Commonwealth ready to put aside its pride and take the assistance when it is offered. I can see I was premature with that expectation. Very well. We're leaving. Make it quick, please.
Yes?
Hey there. That wasn't bad. Shame this turned out to be a waste of time, but we survived fine so far. It'll take a bit longer, but at least we know we didn't sign away our souls. With your help, I'm sure we'll be just fine without her or this trading company. Listen, before we head back, there's something I've been meaning to talk to you about. I've been a Nightingale for a while now, and normally this is the point where shit goes wrong and I'm a lone survivor looking for a change of scenery. So, this might seem like it's coming out of nowhere, but could you use someone like me in one of your settlements?
Of course. Let's do it.
Glad to hear you say that. I'll sleep easier once I'm in a new place, I think. I'll talk to Fiona as soon as I'm back to make my way to... where you want me?
You opening a museum or something?
Thought we had agreed to wait until the diagnostic scanner was operational.
I agreed to put off treatment until tomorrow. Why would I put any stock in those machines when I already have the diagnosis in front of me? Clear as day.
The machine is not the important part. You can't simply take matters into your own hands when things are moving too slow. If you'd waited...
You're eager to lay blame at my feet, Fiona. I said I would hold off on treating this man, and I did not lie to you about my intent.
So did you try to treat him or not? Please, Cassandra, without playing coy. This is important.
Look at the injection site. After all these years, I should hope I have a steadier hand than that. Unless you also wish to accuse me of becoming old and rickety.
I didn't mean... Wait, Cassandra! Damn it.
Hi.
That went poorly. I can't say she's entirely wrong to be upset with me. I can't exactly rule her out, but if she didn't do it, someone else had to have.
What happened? Why are you so upset?
I found this patient dead an hour ago. When we picked him up off the streets, he was sluggish but aggressive. Raider from a nearby gang, I think. We weren't sure what was wrong with him. Cassandra guessed it might be rabies and developed a cure. I asked her to hold off on it.
What do you think of her?
My first thought was that she simply got tired of waiting. You heard her, she doesn't respect the pre-war tech anyway. If she thought a patient would slip away waiting, she could have taken matters into her own hands. But it just doesn't feel right. I've known her for so long. We have our differences, but I've never known her to not own up to her mistakes. It's just not how we do things here. But if it wasn't her or wasn't her vaccine, then someone else killed this patient. And that's it's even worse.
I'd be glad to help if I can. Have any advice on what I should investigate?
I'm not sure. There's got to be something around, right? Or maybe someone saw something. It'd be nice to know exactly what killed him. Maybe it'd narrow it down. It's a shame the diagnostic machine went down again.
Have any ideas?
I think it'd be a good idea for you to talk to Cassandra. She likes you. Maybe she'll stop evading questions long enough to get the truth out. We don't exactly have quick ways of conducting forensics besides the machines in the diagnostic wing, and they're unreliable.
I'll get right on it.
Thanks. I'll try talking to some of the others, too. Come back to me if you find anything.
Why bother? That's just garbage. I toss it.
Back again. I don't blame Fiona for jumping to conclusions. I'm sure she's already feeling guilty enough.
What's this all about?
Finding an empty syringe in a hospital is not surprising. What's more telling is that I'd prepared two doses of a vaccine, and one is missing. Two points that are not mutually exclusive, but do make for a curious coincidence. Here's the other dose, in case you get the machines working.
Have any advice on what I should investigate?
A murder suspect giving advice to the investigator. Now that has a nice irony to it, but I'll take it as a good sign. If you have the time, you can look through my books on pathology. That is, if you were doubting my diagnosis and have the aptitude for it, of course. If you've any technical skill, perhaps you could try repairing the diagnostic scanner. And lastly, I would advise that you consider why someone might do this, and what might happen to them should Fiona find them out.
That's all for now. Hey there.
Hey, I know this isn't exactly your problem, but I don't know what to do, and I could use your opinion, especially if Cassandra really did do this.
I'd be glad to help if I can. Have any advice on what I should investigate?
I'm not sure. There's got to be something around, right? Or maybe someone... It's a shame the diagnostic machine went...
Yeah? Why is that?
It keeps coming online and then going on the fritz again. I'm not much of a mechanic, but I wanted to time the on window to die. I suppose... I just got it working. We could have used...
I'll get right on it.
Thanks. I'll try talking to some of the others, too.
Did she seem angry at all, agitated, or distracted?
No, she seemed normal. Maybe a little stressed.
Ellis, I know she's been your mentor for a while now, but believe me, I don't want her to be guilty any more than you. If you can think of anything...
I know, but maybe...
Oh, enough of this! Once of watching all of you, you think I can't find a vein? You were off playing with the new toys. Cassie was sulking. And the rabid dog? He was about to chew through the straps. Hell, far as I could tell, he'd have chewed off his own damn arm just to get at us. Cure was sitting already. Either he'd croak or he'd get better. Win-win. So I did my job and took the f***ing guesswork out of it.
Leave the room, please. I have to think about this.
Fiona.
You too, Ellis. I need to talk to our friend here before I make any decisions.
Come on, kid. Let's give the lady some space.
What a load of crap.
Why don't you believe his story?
I know Raphael. If he'd killed that patient, it would have been with a knife, not a syringe. And he definitely wouldn't have bothered lying about it. And all that stuff he said about having a chance of curing the patient? No, no way.
You sure about this?
Raphael cares about us, the Nightingales. He only cares about the patients as far as making sure they're not a threat to us. A cured and healthy raider is no better than a sick one to him. Maybe even worse.
There's more to this story.
Could you talk to him? If he's the only one confessing and we don't have the full picture, then I'll have no choice but to... I don't even know. I've sent volunteers away before for breaking our rules. I can't even think of doing the same to him. But if he really killed that man, I couldn't trust him around patients ever again. Much as it breaks my heart.
Hey there.
She make up her mind or what?
I don't buy your whole story.
Shit. If you're not buying it, means Fiona isn't gonna settle on it either. Can't say you weren't decent to me. Hell, I'd even call you a friend. Last thing I thought I'd ever say about someone like you. That's the problem with you, and Fee, Cassie, Alice, all so bent on giving me more credit than I... I wouldn't lay a finger on the guy unless asked. Not that they ask much. They like the whole merciful end thing, and I'm more old-fashioned. I did kill him, though. Didn't lie about that. Better it be me that does it.
What do you mean?
Exactly that. Unlike the Nightingales, I don't cry myself to sleep over putting down some idiot half-dead with a broken spine in a ditch somewhere. Better it's me that pulls those triggers. What else am I good for? I don't make a pretty nurse, that's for sure.
That's all I needed to know.
Hey, are you done with investigating? What do you think happened? Was it really Raphael? I still find that so hard to believe.
Took one chem too many.
Ah, that's right. I see.
That's right what? Do you two know something?
Fiona, the diagnostic machine requires a certain preparation procedure before scanning the internal organs, correct?
That's right. It needs a radioactive tracer injected into the bloodstream in order to... Oh.
A pre-war radioactive tracer, I'd assume. One that carries the risk of mutating the virus further, amongst all other possible complications.
Where is my head? But I tested it on a blood sample first. I had no idea he'd receive the vaccine immediately after I prepped him.
Of course. And that's exactly why I believe it's time for me to leave my position here.
Leave? Cassandra, even if you injected him, there's no need for such dramatics. We can sort this out.
I'm not storming out in a huff, my dear. It's time we face the simple truth in front of us. My vaccine could have saved the man's life. And you weren't wrong in waiting to diagnose him conclusively before acting. Yet for all our good intentions, he's dead.
You're saying we have too many cooks in the kitchen. Any other day I would argue, but after this incident, I think you may be right. To be clear, did you inject him with your vaccine?
Does it matter who did what? The man won't get any livelier.
I'll take that as a yes.
Hey.
Everything all right? I realize that Raphael can come off a bit standoffish, but he deserves a chance, same as everyone else.
Reminds me of the grandson I never had, or wished for.
Inject him with your vac-
Does it-
Take this the wrong way, but you're sharper than I thought. Didn't figure that ship with the rabid raider would shake out this even. Could have just blamed me and called it a night, but you didn't. Thanks for that.
It was the right thing to do.
If you say so.
What will you do now?
I figure this is the cushiest I've been in my whole life. Time to put the work in and keep it that way. Train volunteers to stop dropping ammo when reloading. Patrol around the block. Can't rely on those idiots from Diamond City all the way out here. Though, guess between you and the Nightingales, I'm starting to think maybe I just never looked hard enough. Don't know what I would have done if I had to leave. Probably crawl back to the same old shit I used to do. And die doing it. Just... thanks.
Were you really that bad?
Don't really know. I didn't even call myself a raider for most of it. Like my folks, they didn't call themselves scavers either. They called it adventuring. They'd come home with a bag full of toasters like they'd killed a dragon in a dungeon for it, not some feral in a depot. Never thought twice about picking it up myself when they died. Me and some friends all thought ourselves big heroes on the rise.
What happened after that?
We started out honest, you know. Junkyards, old ruins. Hell, even took on a couple of raider gangs. Word got around, so we started getting merc work. A couple of idiot recruits and a stash of psycho later, and we were robbing travelers to keep food in our bellies and ammo in our guns. By the time those bastards left me for dead in the caravan wreckage, we'd earned the raider thing. Weren't pretending to be anything else either. It's how it goes, I guess. Inch by inch. Maybe one day, the Nightingales will be a cannibal cult or something. But not while I'm around. And I guess not while you're around either.
It all worked out in the end.
Yeah. Guess it did.
Hi.
What's up?